Good day, well-respected audience, and welcome to our next talk, which is today with Dr. Roman Borboa. He is a PhD holder in psychology, to be specific in counseling and environmental psychology, and he is also a world-famous SBS lecturer in organizational behavior and human resource management. Roman, good day.
Good day, Dr. Olds. It's a pleasure to be with you today.
Thank you
and
very
your
much.
Audience, of course.
Of course. Thank you so much. Well, today I would like to talk a little bit about the corona crisis and the psychological effects of the corona crisis on people. Actually, we are now facing a health crisis, but I fear that it will shift to a mental crisis. Is that a right statement to make, or is that something we can neglect?
No, you are absolutely right. We already are in the midst of a mental crisis. We have had so many losses due to this coronavirus. It has changed our lifestyles. We are now secluded in our homes or apartments. We have social distance. We are threatened by the erosion of the economic system. We are fearful of the consequences of that, and so forth and so on. So we are living in unusual, uncertain times, and that creates psychological issues such as fear. And that, of course, increases then the possibility, not the possibility, it is already with us, a state of a collective anxiety. You know, we have lost a sense of control. What we have thought we could manage well, not really. We have no control of getting infected when we board a tram, a train, any transportation means, and many other situations. And the potential to get infected is there. It's very, very real, and the consequences are very real as well. And we all are aware of such a possibility. Okay. So anxiety on a collective basis is already here, and that is a mental health issue already.
So what can we do in order to control our emotions? You made the connection before with the coronavirus and its economic impact. We will go probably to a global recession. People will fear to lose their jobs. You know, what can we do to try to control a little bit our emotions? What would you recommend?
Well, you know, the first thing to recognize is that anxiety is a normal state of living under the circumstances that we are experiencing with COVID-19. Okay? Uh-huh. So we need to make people aware of it. But when it becomes a psychological issue is when it gets exacerbated. There are people who can cope with this in a manner that is still adaptive, and there are people who, for various reasons, do tend to exaggerate, and then we get into a state of exaggerated fear, and even panic can come with it. Stress is the bottom line of it. And once we have collective stress, you know, then we need to act. We need to do something, because along with it comes a sense of loss. You know, it is also natural in this state of existence we're living to experience grief and mourning. The problem is that it's something new to us. This is something, a pandemic that this generation has not lived through. And so not only we have anxiety with us, and high levels of anxiety, but a sense of loss. And so we're experiencing what a colleague of mine, Niemeyer, calls collective grief. This is a new thing in that we have no sense of control. You know, we think we can save our children from this. Well, not really. We have lost that sense of control. We cannot predict it. It has been with us. We still don't know where it is going, how it is going to move forward. So it has made our life quite challenging.
Now, can I interrupt you? Because we see in the supermarkets, people are buying materials like crazy. And one of the things which surprisingly continues to go on is people continue to buy toilet paper like there is no end. Is that a more specific example of the loss of control, which you mentioned before?
Exactly. That is a way that many people put into practice to at least have a sense, a sensation that there is some control upon this crisis. And so it triggers behaviors like that. Is there real control? No, there is it's not really control, but it is an artificial means of believing that we can control it. So, and this is something that goes into what we describe in our gremium, in our profession, as ambiguous grief as well, because we have lost that control. This is a sense of losing our attachment to to daily life activities, things, and situations. You know, we have lost our daily routines. We stay home. We need to develop new ones, right?
Talking about the staying home. A lot of our audience is now in home office, but it feels a little bit not so comfortable. You know, it's something new. So, what would you recommend to be a little bit more comfortable in home office? Should we build up a routine, or should we do the work as it comes? What's your recommendation?
Well, absolutely. You know, we know that a sense of calmness can come when you organize your day, give some structure to it. You know, don't let yourself be lost into this in a way that will erode your well-being. Do get up in the morning in a schedule that you put together. Create new routines in that sense. Shower, change, clean clothes, even if you're staying home. And the other thing here is eat healthy. You know, this is not the time to eat pies and cakes and donuts and ice cream and stuff like that. We need to eat healthy, and above all, drink a lot of water. We need to be hydrated, but there are studies coming out of this, trying to understand this virus, that water helps you as well clean your organism and combat this virus. It's a hypothesis. It's not something that has been proven, but certainly is something that can be put into action to help. What else can you do, you know, from this? We don't know what
people. Yeah, I see people. There is a lot of what they say, yoga and meditation. Are these techniques which help you to release your fear?
Yes, absolutely. You know, it's not only about nutrition. It's I always say, you know, it's about exercise, moderation in exercising. I practice every day a half an hour of movement that comes out of my age group on TV. The Prosenectute has some good movements for people my age. So you need to do that so you don't deteriorate in terms of your muscles and ability to move and those kinds of things. A very dear friend of mine has recommended to me the iron board exercise. You go to YouTube and put there iron board exercises, and you will see what you can do. So it's useful. Humor is another thing.
I was going to come to that.
Yes, humor is another activity that certainly helps, even if it is this uncomfortable, this crisis so threatening and so forth. Having a laugh is useful. It increases your optimism and decreases your anxiety. And it's part of the human relations activity. So use it, apply it, but positive humor. The other thing that can be done certainly on top of humor is to do things you enjoy. That's about resilience. You know, how we increase resilience. Dr. Rose, one of your favorite words, I understand, Brazilians, with humor.
Exactly.
You know, resilience is about doing, acting on things and situations in life that you can control. It's not about eroding or letting bad things work on you and eroding your well-being and you, where you don't have control. So go out to the garden, watch the blue sky, enjoy the air enveloping, embracing your body, you know, look at the flowers if you had some there, the grass, the mountains, the horizon. So do puzzles if that's something you enjoy. That will help you cope with the challenges of staying at home and doing work from home as well. Because you need those pauses, you need those breaks as well. And above all, Dr. Rolf, don't let social contacts disappear. Stay in touch with friends, with family. We have these wonderful platforms on videos now that we can stay in touch with all our loved ones, with friends. Use your network, you know. Social life is something that is wiring to us human beings, and we need to be in touch to stay in touch with them, right? Practice cognitions, way of thinking that reduce anxiety. That's the other thing. Some people cannot get rid of thinking about all this bad news we hear all day long. So reduce your exposure to the media channels. You know, watch the news. Yes, once, twice a day maximum. One thing is to be informed, and another thing is to be overwhelmed by bad news that keeps your organism, keeps your body reacting as if you were really in an exaggerated stress situation. So your stress hormones are working all day long, and this only reinforces your anxiety, which can translate then into fear and then into panic, and then one is in need of professional help, which I don't think anyone deserves. You know?
So I'll promise I will not be on the internet and reading every newspaper anymore. So I'll do it only once a day, and I listen to relaxing music with a little sense of humor.
Yes, soothing music is wonderful. Yes, absolutely.
So
there are
Ben,
things you can do, but just do the things you enjoy.
That's the most important. Keep on doing what you enjoy, because then you feel that you're never working at all. So, Roman, I would like to thank you for this wonderful conversation. We have now a new standard phrase, which is stay safe, stay healthy. But I rather take it with a little bit of humoristic approach, as you just suggested. Say, stay rich because you're healthy right now.
Oh, thank you very much. Yes, I will do my best.
Thank you so much for this conversation. Appreciate it. And we keep in touch, as you also suggested.
Thank you. Thank you very much. And also, you increase the wealth and health.
I will do so. Bye for now.
Bye now. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.